Hello, Berkshire Hathaway Home Services sales executives for our video message of the week. All right, today's a really important message because as the market and you get busier and busier, I want to make sure you don't miss some very important steps. What we're going to talk about today, we're going to key in on listings. And specifically is when you're doing a listing presentation, does your presentation truly show client value? You know, step one in any presentation, be it buyers or sellers, you've got to ask questions. And you know, the saying I've said before is if you want great answers and insightful answers, you got to ask great and insightful questions. So that's always important. And some of the needs of the client can be, you know what, outside of the norm. I know we've been talking about, you know, for sellers, they're concerned in selling is one of them is, you know what, I have to find another house. Can you help me? And that's a key if they're concerned about that. And I know you've already been talking about that in all of the branches. That's very important. And you learn that by asking good questions. Another one may be, you know what, I'm willing to lose some money and spend more money on the house because I want to sell it quickly. We talked about that. So you ask questions and you learn that they're more interested in that. You know, they don't want people tramping through their house and they're okay giving up dollars. Today though, I want to go over what happens pretty much 97% of the time. You know what? You'll get some differences based on asking those key, very important questions. But what are we doing in a normal, consistent presentation? Okay, there are two items that come up consistently in one of those normal presentations, and that is, one, get my home sold. Get my home sold, and two, make me the most money. So get my home sold and make me the most money. That's what we're gonna key in on today. And my message for you today is this. Listen. The company has tools, you have marketing that you key in on, maybe you have some specific individual tools that set yourself apart, and that's all great. All of those things are awesome. But here's today's point, is you can't have those things discussed without tying them back to whatever the goal is of the client. You know, sometimes we get excited, let's say you're a successful sales executive, and we get excited about sharing our own success, and that's a beautiful thing. The key is how is your success helping the client sell their house and put more money in their pocket? See, if you're having success just touting, okay, your accomplishments, I promise you, that's not gonna connect as hard as when you talk about your accomplishments and how they're going to put dollars in their pocket and or get their home sold more effectively, quicker, based on their needs. Look, everything you go over, from every tool the company has, to every comment, to every piece of marketing, has to tie back to the client's goals. And if this point is missed, one, because you're busy, two, because you don't think, well, it's not that necessary, they're not worried about those things, I'm telling you, you're going to lose listings because the consumer is focused on their needs. And they don't have the skill set based on what you offer and the tools and the support and really all the things you do behind the scenes. So you've got to share those things and make sure to tie them back to every aspect of their goals. Meaning today, get my home sold and make me the most money. Look, on any other goals that come up within those insightful questions, some that I mentioned earlier, you can tie it back to those. As long as it's absolutely a need and a want for the client, it's a win to tie back. The mistake is when you go over your general presentation and you don't tie it back hardcore to the needs and the wants of the client. The client is truly number one. Okay, and if you feel that way, you got to make sure within every presentation you're sending that message. Have a great week, everybody, and we'll talk to you next week. Bye-bye.